Auntie Dawn was going through stuff, and knowing that you had Grandpa's watch, she thought you might like to have this.
Something from your other grandfather.
Tinfoil? Wow. His money clip.
His money clip,
which now
that's
you can
ironic.
Put your money.
Your money.
Thank you very much. It looks like you guys are being very generous. With thank you.
But now you have something to remember Papa and Grandpa.
And Grandpa.
And you.
And us.
Yes. Yeah. Well, it says
just Tom. But I also love Mom.
More.
Yep. Thank you. These are a gift from Jack and I. Mostly Jack.
Do we just slide the ribbon off, I think?
The first step is a puzzle.
Yes, how do you undo it? That's easy enough.
Good luck, survivors.
There you go.
Mom's into the package first.
Oh.
Oh, that's pretty.
That's very pretty.
Yep, and it's written. There's something in there as well.
Okay.
Oh, that's so sweet. Says, Tom, thank you for being such a loving example of a husband and father. I'm so lucky to be marrying the man you have raised. Thank you for welcoming me into your family. Love, Jack.
It's wonderful.
It's
beautiful. Jack, I'm in the
best. Oh, goodness. And I just dropped mine on the ground.
Right.
That's beautiful. I like that.
Okay, I have one too. Joanne, your son is such a special man, and I know that is true. He would not be the man that I love if it were not for you. Finish reading it for me.
So if upon our wedding day you shed a happy tear, just save it in this hanky and know I hold you dear. Love, Jacqueline. So sweet.
You can use it now if you really want. No better time.
I'm trying to get this tag off here, but I wanted to get a picture of the bracelet too.
It's pretty.
It is very pretty.
Thank you. Thank you. friends and family, we are gathered here today on this most happy occasion to join this man, Nigel Thomas Reel, and this woman, Jacqueline Mackenzie Myers, in holy matrimony. Now, who gives this woman to be married to this man?
Her mother and I.
You may be seated. Beauty is an act of intentionality. As we look around today, we see the fruit of a lot of work to make this space, and yes, these people, pretty beautiful. Albert Einstein once said that there are two ways to see the world, either that nothing is a miracle or that everything is a miracle. And this little hinge of belief can greatly change the way that you see the world and how you respond to it. We all know that the world can seem to be rather chaotic and ugly at times, but in the intricate beauty, we see a clue to something mysterious and profoundly important. You see, the beauty of our stories, what really causes them to be substantial, significant, and meaningful, is that there is a giver, a planner, a miracle worker who is for us. As King David once wrote in Psalm 139, he said, "For you formed my inward parts. You knitted me together in my mother's womb. Your eyes saw my unformed substance. In your book were written, every one of them, the days that were formed for me, when as yet there was none of them." He's speaking of God to God. He's reflecting on the wonder of being part of a bigger picture that is intentionally being painted through the course of history. And this same God who ordered the steps of David orders our steps and ordered your steps, Jacqueline and Nigel. He saw the two of you meeting before that day ever happened many years ago. And he saw this day coming from the beginning of time. No matter which friends and family here saw this special day coming early on in your relationship, God easily wins for having the longest lead time on that one. For that reason, although there are plenty more, I'm going to boldly and unapologetically encourage you to trust him with everything that you are. That includes your marriage. We quote scripture and pray to God during wedding ceremonies because we believe he is the author of marriage, but also because we must humbly admit that we don't know what lies ahead. It could be richer or poorer than you are now, which is part of the reasons why we talked about that in premarital counseling, right? Yeah. And it could also be that it could be healthier or sicker than you are now, which is why we also talk much about caring deeply for each other's needs. We simply don't know the circumstances that are going to come our way. I know you both have, getting to know you more and more over the last couple months, that sense of when I'm committed, I'm committed. Yet in committing to love someone else, no matter the possibilities, we probably should recognize how challenging and even beyond us this will feel at times. That is why we're so fortunate to have the Lord who orders our steps available to us. He plans out the future, and though it will include plenty of challenges, I know that's encouraging to hear, but it's true. He desires good for those who love him and are called according to his purposes. So commit to Jesus's purposes for your lives. That's easily the best marriage advice after all those premarital counseling sessions that I can give. It sums up in that. And learn what it looks like and commit to living out Jesus's purpose for your life. We see some of his purpose when it comes to marriage, traveling back to the very beginning in Genesis when it's first talked about, the way God brought Adam and Eve together in marriage. In chapter 2, verse 18 through 25 of Genesis, it says, "Then the Lord God said, 'It is not good that the man should be alone. I will make him a helper fit for him.' So the Lord God caused a deep sleep to fall upon the man, and while he slept, took one of his ribs and closed up its place with flesh. And the rib that the Lord God had taken from the man, he made into a woman and brought her to the man. Then the man said," and he actually kind of sings it, actually. It's fun. He starts singing, "'This at last is bone of my bones and flesh of my flesh. She shall be called woman because she was taken out of man. Therefore, a man shall leave his father and his mother and hold fast to his wife, and they shall become one flesh. And the man and his wife were both naked and were not ashamed.'" God decided in that moment to make a helper fit for Adam and to offer her as a gift to him, one that he was to cherish and see as a part of his own flesh and blood. This isn't a sort of codependent way of seeing his spouse, but a way that honors her as his in a way that is hard for us to even fathom. Not his as a possession, but as a prized part of his very purpose in life. Nigel, in committing to Jacqueline today, you're receiving a gift, a woman with her own unique DNA, fingerprint, past experiences, and perspective on life will be grafted into your life. She will be bone of your bone and flesh of your flesh. God calls us husbands to not mistreat our wives for that very reason. He even points out later on that we should care for them like we would care for ourselves. And Jacqueline, you're committing to Nigel today, and in doing so, you will share your life with him and also be the greatest help and support to him. Your words and your signs of affection and appreciation will do for him what no others could do. To be clear for the both of you, this will all take a lot of work, which is why we talked about all of that before. And yes, I'm convinced that if we surrender our lives to Jesus, that he can help us rise up and meet the task. But even in that, we still need to meet the task. I began by saying that beauty is a sign of intentionality. And a beautiful marriage is not one that happens by accident, but very intentional, even if at times incredibly simple, things that each of you do will make your marriage even more and more beautiful many years from now than it will be today or tomorrow. So Nigel, I now ask you, Nigel, do you take Jacqueline to be your lawful wedded wife, to love her, comfort her, honor her, and keep her in sickness and in health, committing to live sacrificially towards her as Christ loved the church for as long as you both shall live?
I do.
Jacqueline, do you take Nigel to be your lawful wedded husband, to love him, obey him, honor him, and keep him in sickness and in health, committing to submit to his leadership as we are all called to submit to Christ for as long as you both shall live?
I do.
Now that you have made these vows to God for your intentions going into marriage, it is time to share the vows that you will make specifically to each other. And so, Nigel, repeat after me. I, Nigel, take you, Jacqueline. To be my wedded wife.
To be my wedded wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better or for worse.
For better or for worse.
For richer or for poorer.
For richer or poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till God by death separates us.
Till God by death separates us.
And to you I pledge my faithfulness.
And to you I pledge my faithfulness.
Jacqueline, repeat after me. I, Jacqueline, take you, Nigel.
I, Jacqueline, take you, Nigel.
To be my wedded husband.
To be my wedded husband.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better or for worse.
For better or for worse.
For richer or for poorer.
For richer or for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till God by death separates us.
Till God by death separates us.
And to you I pledge my faithfulness.
And to you I pledge my faithfulness.
The union and new family that begins with Nigel and Jacqueline getting married today is the product of the families that each of them come from. As a way of honoring those families and how they poured deeply into these two, we are going to have a special symbol, a planting of a seed, where Nigel and Jacqueline will, together, place the seed in the soil and move the soil over that seed, and then where their mothers will come together and water that new seed. Something new begins here today that was not here before, but it is a product of what came before, and we honor that. Nigel, what token do you give as evidence that you will keep your marriage vows?
I have this ring.
Nigel, take this ring and place it on Jacqueline's left hand and repeat after me. With this ring. I pledge my faith and trust.
I pledge my faith and trust.
Receive it as a symbol. Of our endless union.
Of our endless union.
And our unbroken love.
And our unbroken love.
Now, Jacqueline, what token do you give as evidence that you will keep your marriage vows?
This ring.
Jacqueline, take this ring and place it on Nigel's left hand and repeat after me. With this ring.
This ring.
I pledge my faith and trust.
I pledge my faith and trust.
Receive it as a symbol.
Receive it as a symbol.
Of our endless union.
Of our endless union.
And our unbroken love.
And our unbroken love.
Let's pray a blessing over this couple. God, we thank you so much for your love, your grace, and your kindness, that you have shown us perfect love in Jesus, and that you have allowed us to experience love in so many different capacities, but there is such a great love that is held between a husband and wife. And in today's ceremony, we are not only acknowledging the love that has existed between Nigel and Jacqueline, but we are watching as they commit in front of us as friends and family to continue to love, no matter what may come, each other and only each other in the way that you've called them to. God, we thank you for the gift of marriage. We thank you for the way that you wove their stories together, brought them to this point. We pray incredible blessings. God, would you make your face to shine upon them? Would you allow them to see so much good in their life and to weather the storms that are bad together and be stronger for it? God, would their marriage be one where they would be able to multiply the wins and divide the losses because of the strength of the other person that they're married to? God, would you allow us as friends and family to be those who would speak kindly to them and supportive of them, and we would be champions of this marriage and this union? God, we thank you that you can hold together what man would try and separate, that you can hold together what even the enemy would try and separate. Would you hold them together? And would their marriage be one of beauty that comes from intentionality, that years and years from now, they look back on this day and think, wow, we were so much in love then, but we love each other so much more now. Jesus, we thank you for your love. In your name we pray. Amen. So now, having heard you make these pledges of your affection and take these vows of fidelity, I do by the Church of the Lord Jesus Christ and the laws of the State of Virginia now pronounce husband and wife, no longer two, but now one in the eyes of the law and in the eyes of our Creator God. Amen. Which means, Nigel, you may now kiss your bride. And that also means that, ladies and gentlemen, I now have the distinct honor and privilege of introducing to you for the very first time, Mr. and Mrs. Real. You are the best thing. You are the best thing. You are the best thing. Ever. And family, I'd like to ask those of you who are family, you know, to please remain here for the family photos that are going to be happening right now. So if you're family, please remain here. And if you're not family, we kindly ask and invite you to go out to the barn for a cocktail.
I feel. So let's put them all together, and I'll ask you a simple question. Are you guys excited for Nigel and Jacqueline, ladies and gentlemen? All right. Welcome. Welcome. This is a beautiful venue, Eden Try Winery and Estates. I know the folks have done a wonderful job getting everything ready. Speaking of which, there are a lot of folks here that have been working really, really hard, including Chrissy, our director, our bartenders, our photographers, videographers. Everyone's been working really hard, including Shane with the Silly Shots. Also, Country Lane. They're our caterers for this evening. They've been working really hard also. I do not want to leave anyone out. So if you would please give each and every one of them a huge round of applause. And I saved this one for last, but I would like for you, if you would please, to give Jonathan a nice round of applause. Just a couple of quick announcements. Our photo booth with Shane Silly Shots will be open until around 8 this evening if you've not gotten your photos done. The bride and groom would request that you do that sometime this evening. Also, there is a guest log. Make sure that you sign that sometime this evening. So I'll ask you one more time, are you guys excited to be here this evening, ladies and gentlemen? Are you guys excited for Nigel and Jacqueline, ladies and gentlemen? Without further delay, please direct your attention to our main entrance for some very special introductions. Ladies and gentlemen, first of all, welcome our beautiful flower girl, Tegan Flynn. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome bridesmaid and friend of the bride, Lindsay Southworth, and groom's gal, Sophie Klein. Please put your hands together for bridesmaid and sister of the bride, Madison Myers, and groomsman, Bob Pilgrim. Please welcome our maid of honor and sister of the bride, Stephanie Myers, and groomsman, Glenn Bossy. Ladies and gentlemen, our matron of honor and best friend of the bride, Katie Lynn Miller, and our best man, Ian Thompson. One more time, ladies and gentlemen, if you would, a huge round of applause for our entire wedding party. I'll ask you one more time, ladies and gentlemen, are you excited for our bride and groom? On behalf of the bride and groom, we want each and every one of you to have a wonderful time this evening. I'm going to ask you one more time. Are you excited for our bride and groom, ladies and gentlemen? At this time, ladies and gentlemen, if you would please stand and welcome Nigel and Jacqueline Reel. Nigel and Jacqueline, ladies and gentlemen.
Should this be the last thing I see? I want you to know it's enough for me. It's all that you are is all that I'll ever need. So in love. So in love. So in love.
Cause all that you are is all that I'll ever need. So in love. So in love.
One more time, ladies and gentlemen, give it up for Nigel and Jacqueline. At this time, if you would please welcome the father of the bride to the dance floor as he shares a special dance with our bride this evening.
Look at the two of you dancing that way, lost in the moment. In each other's face, so much in love, you're alone in this place, like there's nobody else in the world. I was enough for her not long ago. I was her number one, she told me so, and she still means the world to me, just so you know. So be careful when you hold my girl. Time changes everything, life must go on. I'm not gonna stand in your way. I loved her first, I held her first, and a place in my heart will always be hers. From the first breath she breathed, when she first smiled at me, I knew the love of a father runs deep. And I prayed that she'd find you someday. But it's still hard to give her away. I loved her first. How could that beautiful woman with you be the same freckle face? Kid that I knew, one that I read all those fairy tales to, and tucked into bed all those nights. And I knew the first time I saw you with her, it was only a matter of time. I loved her first, I held her first, and a place in my will always be hers. From the first breath she breathed, when she first smiled at me, I knew the love of a father runs deep. And I prayed that she'd find you someday. But it's still hard to give her away. I loved her first. From the first breath she breathed, when she first smiled at me, I knew the love of a father runs deep. Someday you might know what I'm going through, when a miracle smiles over you. I loved her first.
Ladies and gentlemen, give it up if you would please for Steve and Jacqueline. At this time, if you would please welcome our groom and his mom to the dance floor as they share a special dance together.
Mama told me when I was young, sit beside me, my only son. Listen closely to what I say.
Give it up, if you would, please, for our groom and his mom, Joanne. All right, so there are four people we have not mentioned tonight. So I'm going to ask Steve and Tammy to come on up, and Tom and Joanne, if you would please come on up. Without these four people, we probably wouldn't be here today. So at this time, I'm going to turn the mic over once again. Give it up for the father of the bride, ladies and gentlemen.
Thank you. Just looking out across, you know, I see so many friends and family from. Hey, yeah, there you go. So my mic's on. Nice, check one. Hey, I see so many friends and family that we've just known for so long. You know, friends going back over 30 years, and then new friends that we're just getting to know, and family. We really, really appreciate everybody coming to sharing this special day. We welcome all of you. We hope that you get some time with the bride and the groom, and to possibly make new friends here. And again, we just appreciate just giving your time to start this couple off right. Thank you so much.
I echo all of that. Thank you. No, seriously, we couldn't be happier. Nigel has been deeply in love with Jacqueline for many years, and this is just a culmination of that love, and we are so happy to have her and her family part of our extended family. So, thank you. All right, I guess it's time for me to say the blessing, so if you could please bow your heads. Dear Lord, we thank you. We thank you for the beautiful weather that we had today, although a little hot. We thank you that all these people traveled from so far away to be able to share in this moment and to create this memory for Nigel and Jacqueline. We thank you for all the family that could not be here, but send their blessings. We appreciate all of you. Lord, we ask for a special blessing on this couple. May you watch over them, guide them, light their path, and bless them with plenty. Lord, we ask that you bless this food that we are about to eat, and we thank you for the fellowship we're about to enjoy. In Jesus' name, amen.
One more time, the parents of the bride and the parents of the groom, ladies and gentlemen. So now give it up for Ian, Katie Lynn, and Stephanie, if the three of you would come on up. I believe you guys are going to be toasting our bride and groom. Come on out here. Give it up for Ian, ladies and gentlemen. He is not nervous at all, are you?
Okay. Can you all hear me? Perfect. You know what they say, they save the best for last, so that's why I'm going first. So I want to thank everybody for coming out today to witness the union of Nigel and Jacqueline. So for those of you who don't know, I'm Ian Thompson. Nigel and I have been friends since high school. So we've been friends since like 9th, 10th grade, and we had a couple of classes together. We'd hang out at lunchtime, and then one Friday he said, hey, do you want to come over to my place and have a sleepover for the weekend? And all I could do is look at him and say, well, I don't know. And he says, what do you mean you don't know? And it's like, well, no one's ever asked me that before. So I had to go and ask my dad. He's like, okay, so go out. We spent the whole weekend playing video games and watching cartoons, and it was just pure. It was just a moment where we became best friends in just one little weekend. So, sorry, let me hold it closer. So during high school, we'd spend a lot of time together. We'd do everything together. And, you know, college, we got separated, you know, not permanently, but, you know, we'd see each other on the holidays. And every time we'd see each other throughout the years, we'd always have these, you know, moments where it just came back to that simpler time where we were just best friends and we didn't have to worry in the world. So when I first heard that Nigel had met Jack, I asked him, I said, well, what do you think of her? You know, what's she like? He's like, it's the happiest I've ever been in my life. And it was as simple as that. And I knew it was true because the first time I met them, they looked at each other as if no one else was in the room. Like, no one else even mattered. Because honestly, no one else did matter to them. And it's just pure joy and happiness, and you could see the love immediately when they first met. And I've known them since they've been together, and it's just fantastic. Glad to see that Nigel's cheesing behind me. Looks like I'm doing a good job. Great. Thank you for that. But I wish them all the happiness in the world, but I really don't have to wish them that because I know that they already have it. I just hope that they hold on to it for the rest of their lives together. My name's Ian Thompson, and I'm done my best man speech.
Good evening, everyone. For those of you who don't know who I am, I'm Stephanie, Jacqueline's favorite, I mean her older sister.
Is this better?
Okay. I'm going to read this because otherwise I'm going to not do good. First, I'd like to start off by thanking everybody for being here. Everybody, you know, thank you for traveling out here. You've helped make this day extra special for Jacqueline and Nigel. And also thank you to everybody who helped all the planning and making sure that everything was perfect, exactly what Jacqueline wanted. Okay, now I'm going to do this part. So, when Jacqueline first asked me to be her maid of honor, I was super excited. I couldn't wait to start the shopping, the planning, and all of the fun parties, and then I remembered about this speech. So, in preparation, I've watched just about every movie I could find that had maid of honor speeches. So if you're a movie nerd and you think you recognize any of these lines, you don't, I promise. But really, Jacqueline, I'm so happy to stand by your side as you marry the love of your life. And Nigel, I'm so excited to now be able to call you my brother-in-law. You know, when I first started thinking about what I wanted to say in this speech, all I could think was, holy crap, my little sister's getting married. It feels like it was just yesterday that Mom and Dad brought you home, and you slowly started to take over everything. All of the attention that I used to get, all of my toys, my room, everything. Sorry, Nigel, now she's going to do that to you. In all honesty, some of my favorite childhood memories came from when we shared a room. Like the time you didn't want that baby bird to be alone, so you tried to hatch it under our bed. She has a really good heart, but that was disgusting. And Mom got pretty mad. Or all the times that we drove our parents crazy by making dance routines and music videos when we should have been sleeping. Or laughing hysterically at random things, again, when we should have been sleeping. Or when we were play games like The Floor is Lava, again, when we should have been sleeping. Even though that one didn't really turn out so great, Jacqueline ended up in a neck brace. Still is a wonderful story, and still one of my favorite memories. But my point is, growing up with you and Maddie has been the best. Full of so much love and laughter, and I'm so lucky to be your big sister. Almost done. Being your big sister has always made me a little extra protective of you. Nobody other than me was going to be able to mess with you. So naturally, when Nigel showed up, I was a little bit nervous and I had to make sure he was just right for my little sister. So I had a couple tests. First test was, one, if you can handle our family, and anybody that knows our family can understand that. So I figured, you know, if you go to a few events, I probably wouldn't even have to worry anymore because you might not even still be here. But he passed. Not only did he make it through the family events, but he willingly came back to more. After hanging out with Jack and Nigel a few times with the family, he passed my second test, personality. He was able to keep up with the craziness of the Myers sisters, and turns out he's actually a little bit funny. As time went on, I knew I had nothing to worry about. I could tell how much he loved Jack by the way he would look at her, and I could see how happy they made each other, which brings me to the last test, and that was whether my sister was happy. I remember one conversation in particular with Jack. We were in Texas and staying up late one night talking, and she told me how happy she was and how in love she was and how she knew Nigel was the one. You know, someone once told me that true love is the soul's recognition of its counterpoint in another, and I think that's a very rare thing in this world, and I'm just very happy that my little sister found it. So, Nigel, you've made it. And now, not only do you get to marry my wonderful and beautiful sister, but you get to have me as your sister-in-law. So, Jacqueline and Nigel, I wish you nothing but the best, and I love you both so much.
Hi, I'm Katie Lynn. I'm Jacqueline's best friend. Only friend. Hey, Lindsay now. Up until recently, only friend. I want to start by addressing Nigel, and also I can't do this without reading, so. Who for the past 5 years has loved Jacqueline so very well. When I first met him, I knew he was different. I have no doubt. I mean, that's obvious. I have no doubt that he will continue to be her best friend and advocate in marriage. I've seen Jacqueline in every mood imaginable, but I've never seen her happier than when she is with you. 3 years ago, Jacqueline stood by me as the maid of honor at my wedding, and I'm pleased to be the same for her as the matron of honor because I got married first. Jacqueline and I have been friends for well over a decade, actually 15 years, a decade and a half. In that time, so much has changed. In these past 15 years, there were engagements, weddings, new homes, new jobs, new haircuts, and you even got to watch me have a daughter. In the same vein, when we're together, it's like nothing has changed at all. From rocking out to Paramore in the car, sitting in the back of my mom's van pretending she's our chauffeur, spending hours in the mall buying nothing but trying on everything, Taco Bell and seeing terrible horror movies every single Friday of high school, and family vacations. We had never had a hard time having fun. Thank you for being the definition of a friend to me all these years, even when we were just acquaintances. Watching you grow up alongside me through everything has been the greatest gift of my life. I want to end this by thanking everyone for joining us today and for everyone who made this absolutely perfect for us because of what I already mentioned. Congratulations again to the new Mr. and Mrs. Real. And if everyone would raise their glass for the beautiful couple, here's to a life of love, laughter, and happily ever after.
Alright, so we're going to play a game. Some of you know Jacqueline really well, some of you know Nigel really well, some of you may know them both, but we're going to play a game now called the Stew Game to see how well they know each other. So we already know who takes the longest to take their shoes off. But it's okay, we'll get there, right, Nigel? So each one of them have one of their shoes and one of their spouse's shoes, all right? Spouse, can you say that, Nigel? Can you say it? Spouse, all right, very good, very good. Hopefully you can say it happily after this game. So nevertheless, so each one of you have one of your shoes and your spouse's shoes, and I'm going to ask you a series of questions. And you're going to raise one shoe, Nigel. One shoe, Jacqueline. No more. All right. Only one shoe. So make sure Nigel understands the game real well. We're going to do a test question. All right. Nigel, are you ready for the test question? All right. So right now, right this second, which one of you has the most time on you? Lift your shoe high. You can play through there, Jacqueline. Lift it high. All right. Very good. Very good. A good question about money, Nigel. You're on the right track. Give Nigel a nice round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. So, in your relationship, there you go. You got fans out there, all right? So in your relationship, who made the first move? Inquire minds want to know what was the first move. That's good enough, all right? That's enough right there. Who's the better driver? Who's the faster driver? You guys are doing great. Who's more stubborn? Well, at least you got it right, too. Well, maybe. I don't know. Who's better at keeping surprises? Who is more likely to be running late? Did you get here on time, Nigel? You got it. You're here on time. You were waiting on her to go. Well, there you go. Because you were in charge, right? Who said I love you first? Jacqueline. Who said I love you first? No, it was Dad. It was Dad. Where's Dad? There he is, over there. Just do the next thing, all right? And tell me if I don't know that though, but I'm just kidding. I'm sure you are, but who will be the first between the two of you to mention children? Has she already mentioned children? She has. Was it this year? It was not this year, was it last year? Steve, did you hear that? Who talks more? Who is the first to make up after a big fight? Wait, for the next question. Who started the big fight? Mixed emotions on that. All right. One more question. All right. One more question for you. Can never take chances with this last question. Who do you love the most in the whole wide world? Ladies and gentlemen, give it up if you want to for a blind man. Hey, so you guys, we're going to move the series and we're going to move the stairs. We're going to start some dancing, but what I want you all to do is get up and assume that slow dance position that you had earlier. So right here in the middle of the floor, we'll move these out of the way. Assume that slow dance position you had earlier. And I want to know what you think, guys. Tell me how good they look by your applause. What do you think? All right. And you see, they're dancing to your applause. They're just moving around here in a circle. So if you're here tonight and you're married, let's see, grab your spouse, come on up to the dance floor. Put your arms around your spouse, ladies and gentlemen, just like Nigel and Jacqueline. Here we go. You guys are all looking for this. Together, Come on here. Yep. If I had been married 5 years or less, 5 years or less.
Your God with all your heart and with all your soul and with all your mind. I'm
Damn, he's all the way in
there. Yeah.
Oh, I'm
We'll be right back.